fellow Avid carpers, and look at this one. This one really is next level. Not the biggest one I've had, but certainly the prettiest in this session. So in the next few minutes, I'm going to teach you and show you about the new Avid bobbins, from fishing ultra long range right through to fishing under your rod tips in the margins with slack lines. So sit back and enjoy. Long range fishing and zig fishing. I use the same arrangement with my bobbins in this situation. I like to keep a very tight as I can get away with, obviously without moving the lead. And I keep it tight because the fish obviously can move away from you, so you'll get the bobbin moving away, but it can also drop back, like so. But also you can get a lateral movement, and that is when the fish is moving side to side. And that is when you may only just get one beep, and you have to watch your line moving left and right. The reason I don't fish a slack line for zig fishing or for long range fishing is because I want every indication to be transmitted through to my bobbin, through to my alarm, to let me know what's going on. If I was fishing a slack line, that indication would be taken up by the slack outside in the lake and not registering as quickly on my bobbin. Here we go, Avid carpers, another cracking mirror caught at long range, fishing the bobbins hard to the top. I managed to get a big drop back that registered nicely on the new bobbins. And here we go, a nice fish just under 20 pounds. Here we have a nice margin caught mirror. I saw a few fish yesterday evening moving around in the edge. So I flicked a rod out down there, settled the line down nice and slack, changed over to a long chain and fished a mega slack line, and this one screamed off in the early hours. Yesterday evening I saw a few fish just mooching around the edge, having a little feed and looking like they were interested. So I plopped some bait in the edge and watched them, and I thought, well, it's probably worth sticking a rod down there. So I flicked a rod out, walked it back down, let the line sink, and I came back to my rod rest and set up the longer chain with the bobbins. So all through the evening I was getting small line bites, like so. Not quite takes, just little line bites lifting up and down, like so. And then finally I got a take in the night and it totally screamed off, like so. So the reason I've set my bobbins nice and slack in the edge is I want my line pinned down along the bottom, but I also want to know if I've got fish coming in, okay, getting my line bites. And also you can fish slack lines in the edge because there's only one way the fish is going to run, and that's away from you. It's not going to run towards you to get a drop back or laterally, it's always going to run away from you. So you can fish this technique and it seems to work with a cracker. So there we have it, Avid carpers, my quick guide to short range and long range bite indication. I hope it's been useful to you, and I hope it puts a few extra fish on the bank.